Alabama today takes on Art Bravo Auburn. Alabama 1-3 on the season. Their only win, though, coming on the road against LSU. The lights have been dimmed. And, Joe, you talk about the emotion of this game. I mean, people talk about the Auburn-Alabama rivalry 365 days a year.
But you see the series records right there. And, Bob, you're right. The intensity level of this series between Alabama and Auburn starts in football in the fall and carries over throughout the year. And when these two teams meet, what's that old cliche? You can throw the record books out the window.
Last year, they split two games. Auburn won 72-62, and in Tuscaloosa, Alabama won 55-50. Alabama, though, has had some good success against the Tigers in recent seasons, and so they hope to keep it up today. Starting lineups have been introduced for Cliff Ellis's Auburn Tigers. And, you know, yesterday, Joe, it was an interesting day in the SEC. We mentioned in the opening that Ole Miss lost at Tennessee. Tennessee played one of its best games of the season, depleted in talent with all the injuries. And then the great game up at Rupp Arena when Kentucky outlasted Arkansas in overtime. So that changes the complexity here in the West.
Well, you're right. A bad day in the SEC West yesterday, Bob, as you mentioned. Of course, Arkansas lost, Ole Miss lost, Mississippi State all lost to Eastern Division teams. LSU, the only Western Division team to beat an Eastern Division team yesterday. They went to Gainesville and won 66-63. This is a big one here today, as we talked about in the open, for Auburn to really establish more credibility for their program. To go 3-1 in the league, tie for first in the West early, would be a big push for them.
See David Hobbs, the head coach of Alabama, in his sixth year, the record 104-68. His teams have won 8 of the last 9 meetings, though, with that guy's team. Cliff Ellis, now in his fourth year at Auburn and his 23rd year overall as a head coach. And Cliff Ellis has his team off to a very good 2-1 start, their best start in the SEC since 1988. The officials, David Dodge, the lead official, Terry Sitton, and Jamie Jones. Hayes will jump center against Njai. And they're making sure that Doc Robinson has his feet not tangled up with Demetrius Alexander. Bob Kessling and Joe Dean, glad you're with us today, and we're underway. Alabama and Auburn.
Auburn always runs a double screen for the center to start the game. It's a set play on the jump ball, but that time Alabama defended it well.
Scott Pullman, the freshman guard, came right in and started. Brian Smith with the ball now, back to Pullman. Joe, both these teams are playing pretty good defense on the air.
They really are.
Pullman, a runner, no good. And the rebound put back up and in by Njai.
Mamadou Njai leads the SEC in blocked shots, but he's really improved inside with his strength, rebounding, and that time you saw a good offensive putback. Cliff Ellis will like that.
Chauncey Jones tries to hit Hayes inside, and the ball sails out of bounds. Turnover, Alabama.
Last year, I don't know if Mamadou Njai would have had the strength to do this. Jeremy Hayes is out of position, going for the block. Njai in position and the putback.
Alabama, the leading rebounding team in the SEC, and it's something that Cliff Ellis emphasized yesterday. Got to get on the board. Smith misses that one. The box out, but Alabama comes out of there with it. Jones to the basket. Short on it. And Brian Smith gets the rebound. 2-0 Auburn. Njai's and Hayes. Oh, he double dribbled. He knew what he wanted to do.
Yeah, the move was great. I think he was hoping the official wouldn't notice. But the double dribble on the baseline. But Mamadou Njai very much improved this year. A 7-footer out of Dakar, Senegal. And he has made great strides and has Cliff Ellis excited about the future of this Auburn basketball program.
And there's another pass that just sails out of bounds. Demetrius Alexander tried to throw it cross court to Brian Williams. The ball sails away. 2 turnovers.
Now you see the kind of problems that Alabama has had all year. They are last in the SEC in shooting, and they've just been out of sync offensively much of the season, but have played excellent defense. They lead the SEC in defending the field goal.
And Hayes blocks. knocks that one out of bounds. And as the block was made, Doc Robinson grabbed it, but he was standing out of bounds.
Well, Bob, in this game, you've got four guys who really are excellent shot blockers. Hayes and Alexander for Alabama, Mamadou Indjai, and Randy Hughes for Auburn, although Randy Hughes has been suspended today for violating team policy, will not play.
Hayes, a little short on the shot over Indjai. Alabama yet to score, and Auburn leads it. Smith's first shot. That's a three.
Well, you saw Bryant Smith post up in an earlier possession. That time, he went outside in the motion offense and knocked down the three. Very versatile player, Bryant Smith, a junior out of Butler High in Huntsville.
Go back inside to Hayes, and he shoots over Indjai, misses this time. Alabama on the offensive glass, and they get a fresh 35-second shot clock. Williams drops it in again to Hayes. Now Williams a three, and Alabama still can't hit. Hayes on the offensive glass. They won't count the basket, and a foul's going to be called against Auburn. And there's Alabama going to the boards again.
Well, we talked about the defense for both teams. Auburn has had 40 consecutive games, Bob, where they have not allowed their opponents to shoot 50%. Alabama is first in the SEC in the same statistic, defending against the field goal at about 37%. They're actually fifth in the nation, which is outstanding defense.
But Alabama is last in the league in field goal percentage, and they have yet to make a basket or a point. And we're 3 minutes in here today at Auburn. Hayes again gets the look inside, can't handle the pass. Three turnovers now for Alabama, no points. Robinson penetrates, can't score it, so he gives it back out to the governor. And that pass sails into the Cliff Dwellers. Franklin Williams, I think, thought Bryant Smith was cutting the other way.
Now, both teams nervous. This is a big rivalry. A lot of electricity here in Beard East Memorial Coliseum in Auburn. An important game early here in the SEC for both teams.
Bama 0 for 4 from the field to start. Hayes has got a lot of touches so far. Williams fires. That's no good. Now the rebound controlled by Franklin Williams of Auburn.
Trying to figure out what kind of defense Auburn's playing, Bob. It looks like man-to-man, but they've been known to play a lot of triangle and two, and they disguise it very well.
Doc Robinson, that's a two. And it's 7-0 Tigers.
Well, Doc Robinson was Alabama's Mr. Basketball 2 years ago. A lot of promise when he came here. Really starting to come into his own now in his sophomore season. Youngster out of Selma, Alabama.
Jump shot from the baseline by Rollins is no good. And Auburn gets the rebound again. 4.5 minutes, Alabama's gone without a field goal. Williams, good fake. And it's 9-0. And Alabama wants to talk about it. Auburn off to a 9-0 start. And Alabama can't get anything done offensively right now, Joe.
Now they've been out of sync, as we've talked about, trying to find themselves from the perimeter. Really, Alabama's got a couple of guys inside, as you see David Hobbs talking to his team, that they can go to and score. Hayes inside at 6'10", and Alexander is also a good offensive player inside. Watch Franklin Williams here, a senior out of Headland, pump fake on the dribble, nice little jump shot. They call him the governor around here, Bob Kessling.
He's got that look about him. He's already, of course, graduated his undergraduate degree. Now he's in grad school. And he's been a great leader for this Auburn basketball team. You see the woes for Alabama, shooting-wise, 0 for 6.
Auburn now has gone to a 1-3-1 zone. Scott Pullman is on the point. Cliff Ellis loves to change defenses at timeouts and keep the offense off balance.
Alexander working against Indjai, and finally Alabama gets its first bucket.
And that's good coaching right there. David Hobbs called a 20-second timeout and said, fellas, we're going to go inside and put some pressure on the Auburn defense. Alexander is Alabama's best inside scorer.
And also, he must know, with Randy Hughes being out of the lineup, that Auburn doesn't have a lot of depth inside. So Alabama gets its first basket. But Doc Robinson and the Tigers have a 9-2 lead early here in the first half.
Okay, Bongo, wave. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Come on, he's never gonna get it. Finally learned to wave bye-bye.
The new redesigned Ford Ranger. The only compact pickup built Ford tough.
Thinking about your financial future? What better company to place your trust? Top 10 in U.S. life insurance and growing fast. A major provider of annuities, investments, and retirement planning solutions. Manages $22 billion in assets and does it all with some of the industry's highest financial ratings. Jefferson Pilot. Vision to power your dreams.
What makes a Dairy Queen frozen birthday cake so special? First of all, it's made with lots and lots of delicious Dairy Queen chocolate and vanilla soft serve. Everybody's favorite. Plus, there's a layer of chocolate fudge and chocolate crunch. But the icing on the cake is you can get it decorated our way or your way. The Dairy Queen Birthday Cake. There is no other birthday cake quite like it. We treat you right. Dairy Queen.
The Cliff Dwellers here in force today. They've reconfigured the Coliseum here a bit, but they can't seem to shake the Cliff Dwellers. They're here in force.
Cliff Dwellers love it. They were camped outside before the game. And there you see some of the problems we've talked about for both teams. Inconsistent shooting. Auburn 11th in the league. Alabama is 12th in the league in shooting. And today, not much better for Alabama. Auburn off to a good start at 4-for-7.
Alabama's been man-to-man. They're still in it. They throw the ball down low again. Injai, the little hook shot, short. Williams battling on the boards. Out to Robinson for three.
The best way to shoot a three-pointer is to get a pass from the inside out. Franklin Williams got the big offensive rebound, threw it outside, and Doc Robinson has really improved his shooting over the last four or five games.
It's a 10-point Auburn lead. And Doc Robinson has five on the afternoon. Alexander trying to work his way down, but Injai, those big arms, and Pullman gets a hand on the outlet pass. Out of bounds to Auburn. Boy, Injai, he throws those hands up inside. That's a wall.
Good move by Injai. Didn't get it to go, but watch the senior leader of the Auburn Tigers, Franklin Williams. A great board, nice spot up, under control. Doc Robinson plays a little string music. On the planes.
Got it in early today. That's good. Injai again on Hayes. A little up and under move, and he gets the bucket on the foul. I tell you what, we talk about improved players in this league. That's one of them right there.
Bob, you are so right. Mamadou Injai, when he came here a year ago, really could not make this move. But the weight program, the strength around Jeremy Hayes, and is he excited? These Auburn Tigers are emotionally charged here this afternoon. Watch the drop step, spin move right there, up and under, off the glass. And a chance for the three-point play.
Goes to the free throw line. 60% free throw shooter. Leads the SEC's 19th nationally in block shots. Here's that one. He's also improved his free throw shooting. So Auburn continues on the run. It's 15-2 now. Bacot into the game, puts it up, that's no good. Alabama get one shot. Damon Bacot was a late scratch out of the starting line, and now he's in and missed that shot. And Auburn continues on the attack.
A lot of motion in the Auburn offense, five men, no post players, trying to create dribble opportunities to the basket.
Shot clock now under 10. Brian Smith's first shot. That's good, a three. Second shot, excuse me. That's his second three-pointer of the day. Back the other way, a drive to the bucket is good. Let's see if it counts. Foul is going to be before the shot. Brian Williams won't get it. Auburn is 3-for-3 from three-point range. And Brian Smith's got two of them. Doc Robinson has one of them. Robinson sits down and gets a nice round of applause. And into the game comes Damian Fishback. 18-2, Auburn.
And Damian Fishback was Auburn's best three-point shooter in their last game at LSU. He came off the bench and got 13 points. So Auburn's shooting has really picked up here in the SEC season.
Williams for three from the corner. That won't go, but Hayes there to put it back.
Auburn ran zone on the out of bounds. Hard to block out sometimes in a zone.
Fishback hits. And that's a three. It's 21-4.
The offense looks good when you knock them down like Auburn's doing right now. Not much you can say. They're just stepping up and shooting it in the basket.
Alexander blocked by Injai. Alabama back and Fishback waits for help. The governor. Are you kidding me? They are going crazy here at Auburn. In the stands and on the floor. 12:09 to go, and it's Auburn 24, Alabama 4. Jamison End. We'll be back after this message from the Jamison End.
At Jamison Inn, every day in every detail, from our free continental breakfast to the way we say hello, we're different because we're not a franchise. So we have only one way of doing things, the right way. That's why when you check into a Jamison Inn, I guarantee you a perfect stay every time. I'm Tom Kitchen, CEO of Jamison Inns, and that's a promise.
Is there anything more heartwarming than the day a son comes to work for his father?
I don't even want to be in this stupid business.
Oh, that's right. You want to be an author.
You see what he does, Tyler? Just because I
you
want
know,
to write...
I was thinking. You guys could sell a ton more inventory if you use the internet. And all you got to do is write up a little catalog page like that.
So?
So you can write it. Each one of these clubs has got to tell a story, right?
Jerry vigorously grasped the driver in his hands. And...
Of course, you don't have to do it, you know, right now.
NBC Tonight.
Very wonderful for him.
The biggest party of the year.
I salute you.
With the brightest stars of both film and television.
And the winner is?
The winner is everyone who watches it.
There is nothing like it.
The most star-studded award show of them all. The 55th Golden Globe Awards, brought to you by Diet Dr. Pepper. It's the taste you've been looking for. Live, 8, 7 Central, NBC Tonight. Shades optional.
20-point Auburn lead. Auburn's had some shooting woes, Joe, but not today.
Well, the three-point shooting is the story. As you see, Auburn, that's actually wrong. Auburn is 5-for-5 in three-point shooting today. Fishback has come off the bench. Robinson with two and Brian Smith. And Alabama normally is a good defensive team against the perimeter game, but Auburn is just really fired up today, Bob. They're playing at a high level of emotion right now.
And Alabama's only 2-of-11 from the field. Auburn, meanwhile, is 9-of-13, 70% just about.
Auburn is straight man-to-man. They've been disguising their defense some. Straight man-to-man on this possession. Good trap.
Three players circling Baker. Jump shot is way off the mark this time by Neil Ashby. Joe, Alabama just has to dig in defensively and stop this.
Well, the thing is, it's still real early in the game.
Adrian Chilliest on the block, but he has the shot blocked away, and here comes Alabama. Lob pass, and that one rolls off. Ashby tried to get it, would not stay down. It's been that kind of day for Alabama. Pullman's open, no good. Auburn on the board, and Brian Smith puts it in.
And credit Adrian Chilliest for keeping that ball alive on the offensive board. Brian Smith in position to get the putback.
Alabama has scored 4 points in 9 minutes. Another steal. Now it's restolen. Baycote way short. Whistle and a pushing foul inside. It's going to go against Auburn. Chilliest down low. He was pushing against Jeremy Hayes.
Well, Auburn is really hustling today. You see the shot by Pullman, but watch Adrian Chilliest come in here right there, 42, to keep the ball alive for his teammate Bryant Smith. who has as many offensive rebounds this season, Bob, as he does defensive rebounds. Out of bounds play, Auburn goes to the 1-3-1 zone. You'll see him change defenses a lot through the course of the game.
Ryan Williams gets tripped going to the basket. And a couple of Auburn players are down, and Njai painfully gets up, hobbling on that left leg.
Both Njai and Brian Williams are limping, and it's possible they just bump knees with each other. You see the drive, Njai coming over to help.
Ooh, right there, yeah.
Yeah, knee to knee. That's very painful. Chile has tried to take the charge, but the whistle had already blown.
Alabama trying to get anything to go, and finally a jump shot from Brian Williams goes. His first bucket of the day.
Well, he's a guy from nearby Montgomery, played at Jeff Davis High School, and Alabama really counts on him for a lot of offensive firepower.
Njai inside against Taze, tries to get to Coleman, but he dribbles it out of bounds, and the turnover gives the ball back to Alabama. Stay tuned at halftime for Bell South's You Call the Play feature, a look at big plays from SEC games of the past. Jones goes out of the lineup for Alabama. As Alabama tries to get something going, Tarik London comes into the game. Williams, a little pull-up three. No good. Hayes going to the glass, but it goes over the back of Njai.
Alabama right there, Bob, just simply ran a four-man spread where they put their players against the sideline and let Brian Williams go one-on-one from the point. Like to see Alabama maybe try to take it inside a little bit more. Jeremy Hayes is a big, strong kid, and Demetrius Alexander, who's not in right now, had 28 last Wednesday against Vanderbilt. So good inside threat.
You know, they did that early, but they've gone away from it a little bit.
Yeah.
Njai hooks it up, way short, Chiliest underneath, battling, gets it up, and in.
With Randy Hughes out today with the suspension, puts a lot more pressure off the bench on Adrian Chiliest, and so far, he's played well.
Hayes a 15-footer. Njai yanks off the rebound. 28-6 Auburn. Auburn does another player on the bench. Kendall Mack, a football player, came out for practice this week. And so he's on the bench if needed.
Now here you see the shot by Adrian, but watch. Big, rugged Adrian Chiliest, big, strong guy, looks like a football player, out of Little Rock, Arkansas.
Now there's your football player. Big Kendall Mack, they had to get a uniform big enough for him, one specially made.
I tell you, he's more than 317.
Yes. Well, the uniform slims him down a little bit.
You know what bothers me, though, Bob? Yes. Kendall Mack comes out today. He's got his name on the back of his jersey. The two walk-ons over there for Auburn don't have the name on the back of the jersey. Now, if I'm a walk-on, I'm upset by that, you know?
But can you get anything done about that? That's the key.
Well, I may start a walk-on association or something and see what we can do. I feel for those walk-ons.
There you go. Kendall Mack came out trying to get in basketball shape. It'll take him a while, but he'll play some before the season's out. You know that, Joe.
I think Kendall Mack probably demanded he have his name on his jersey, and Cliff Ellis said, yes, sir. Alabama's gone zone, Bob. They're 2-3. They'll match up one on the ball.
Another football player, Clifton Robinson, into the game now for Auburn, number 5. And Fishback hits again. Joe, he's coming out of a shooting slump, isn't he?
He is. He was not shooting well early in the year, but at Baton Rouge last Wednesday night, he came off the bench and lit it up, and he's in rhythm here this afternoon.
Auburn is 6 of 6 from three-point range. Baycook throws it away. Boy, Cliff Ellis' defense has been terrific.
The defense has been outstanding, but a combination of good defense by Cliff Ellis' team and just out-of-sync offense by David Hobbs' team. Alabama just doesn't look like they have any confidence at all.
Caldwell tries one. Tarik Caldwell gets the three. They are 7 for 7 from three-point range, and David Hobbs has to use another timeout to try and slow down this Auburn juggernaut.
Well, there are times in basketball games where your team is just simply unconscious, and that's what's happening today with Auburn. I mean, 7 for 7 from three-point land is amazing. They're confident. They feel it. Their crowd's excited. They're playing for first place in the SEC West. Derek Caldwell, junior out of Brantley High School. The Brantley High School team is here today cheering him on. Tony Stallworth, his high school coach, is with him. And that young man's excited, as are the Cliff Dwellers, and about 10,000 here in Vero Eaves Coliseum in Auburn.
Coming into the game, Auburn had 89 three-pointers. They've already got seven today, and now they're out rebounding, the top rebounding team in the SEC in Alabama. Joe, there's still a lot of time left, though, for Alabama to get back
in.
You
know, Bob, you read my mind, because the one thing that, as Alabama scores there, the one thing Auburn can't do is they can't have a false sense of hope. This game is already over, even though they have the big lead. We've seen leads like this dissipate, and Alabama will turn it up. David Hobbs got after them pretty strong in the timeout.
Zeke gets that tip back in. He just entered the game. Auburn. This is really the first time for a while the shot clock has played into it. Smith hits while falling down. Brian Smith was going down, but he still got his 10th point.
Off the dribble, one-on-one, Brian Smith, probably the most improved player in the SEC, Bob. He has become a big play player and an all-SEC player for Auburn.
Brian Williams challenges Enchai, doesn't win the battle, and Brian Smith comes out of there with it. 7 minutes to go, and Auburn leads it 36-8. His ball, Enchai comes up with it. Robinson gonna try one, that's no good. And Alabama gets the rebound.
Man, it took a football guy to come in and mess up the shooting. You know what?
He had hit one all season. He said, I might as well try one, too.
That's right.
So that, that breaks the string of seven straight three-pointers.
And Cliff Ellis wanted to get Clifton Robinson in the game. Good defensive play there by Robinson. But they wanted to get him in to try to give Doc Robinson a breather.
The no-look pass doesn't work. Alabama throws it away, and Auburn stays red-hot, leading Alabama 36-8.
You don't need binoculars to see why Escort is so popular. It's a value so enticing, it's like getting cake with extra icing. You can get power, lots of power, power galore, to whisk down the windows and unlock the doors, adjust the side mirrors, but wait, there is more. Opt for a remote, AC, a smooth automatic, and a CD player for the music fanatic. And if that's not enough, you can get an anti-theft system to protect this good stuff. The buck starts here for Escort thrills, somewhat higher, loaded to the gills.
Dear BP, what if you had special trucks that could turn into gas stations? Then we could buy what we need and get to where we're going a lot faster. Signed, Dan.
Dear Dan, we keep people moving with Pay at the Pump and our fast BP shops. P.S. We've sent your letter to engineering. Prepay cards from BP are now available and make great gifts.
It's a rough, rough week on the People's Court with a pooch who almost ended up puppy chow.
My dog had close to 70 stitches.
A dog with a disability and a torn-up terrier.
Out of nowhere, this large German shepherd pounced on Oliver.
All new cases that have gone to the dogs.
He brought his dog. You didn't bring your little wolf.
But Monday, it's a dog fight over a dent.
She started kicking on my Jeep. She spit at me, then I spit back at her.
The case of the Cherokee Massacre on the next People's Court.
Weekday mornings at 11 on WSFA.
Wednesday night, be here with us on Jefferson Pilot Sports. The Tennessee Volunteers travel to Columbia to take on the South Carolina Gamecocks. Tennessee off the big win against Ole Miss last night. And South Carolina got a big game today against Georgia. So be with us 8 o'clock Eastern, 7 o'clock Central on Wednesday, Tennessee and South Carolina. Bob Kessling and Joe Dean today, a red-hot Auburn team leading it 36-8. And really, they've taken pretty good shots.
They've taken excellent shots and knocked them down there. They're very emotionally charged. They're focused. They're into their game today. Alabama's been out of sync offensively. And give Auburn some credit defensively as well. Both these teams are good defensive teams.
The governor. Franklin Williams has seven.
They handle the pressure very well right there. Auburn did. Alabama with a token press. Auburn did what you have to do against pressure. Get it to the middle of the floor and take it to the basket.
And now a whistle inside. They say that Chile has threw a knee up against Mazik. So it'll be a foul on Adrian Chilius. That's his second. Doc Robinson has been on the bench for a while with two fouls. And now Chilius has two. That's the fifth team foul on Auburn. Alabama has four. 6:08 to go in this first half. It's a 30-point Auburn advantage.
Auburn on the out-of-bounds play goes back zone, continuing to change from man to zone. They'll pressure Brian Williams on that wing.
Williams thought about it. Now he throws it away. Brian Smith intercepts.
Just not a good decision right there by Brian Williams. Brian Williams actually has more turnovers this season than he has assists, and that's not a good stat for a guy that's playing guard and trying to be a playmaker.
Reverse layup by Franklin Williams. What a half he's had.
The governor is fired up.
At a basket by Brian Williams back the other way, so Alabama finally gets its running game going. For Brian Williams, that was his 1,000th career point. So he joins a very exclusive club at Alabama. Coleman's open for the corner. No good this time. Baycott rebounds. 33rd player in Alabama history to get 1,000 points. So congratulations to Brian Williams.
Good double team there by the Auburn defense.
Alexander, he worked for that one. Draws the foul. Will go to the line.
That's what I was talking about earlier. Demetrius Alexander is 6'8" senior and has excellent skills in the low post. Can put it on the floor and take it to the basket. He actually came out of a double team right there, drove down the baseline, and got himself to the free throw line. Alabama really needs to go to him more often in their offensive sets.
Alexander and Brian Williams, the only two players on the Alabama squad to start all 17 games. And now Blake Thrasher comes into the contest, and Baycoat sits down. Well, David Hobbs has tried a lot of folks on that bench, trying to find something that's going to work. And two free throws for Demetrius Alexander makes it 40-12, and Auburn still maintains the advantage.
And Cliff Ellis is able to rest Doc Robinson with the two fouls, give Scott Coleman some valuable minutes at the point guard position.
Chilius looks for somebody to cut. Decides to take it himself right around Alexander and draws the foul. We'll make that physique over. At the conclusion of this game, we'll be selecting a BP best player from each team. In addition to recognizing our two best players, BP and its dealers will contribute $2,000 to the Southeastern Conference to be distributed among the member institutions' scholarship funds under a conference-approved plan. See Adrian Chilius, solid as a rock out of Little Rock, Arkansas. And he misses the shot.
Chilius is not a big offensive threat for Auburn, but he has to come in today and play a role because Randy Hughes is out, suspended. 6'9 freshman out of Georgia. And so far, Chilius has been a big contributor to this early Auburn lead.
Has 3 points, but he's done a lot of banging inside. As Mamadou Njai now on the bench for Auburn. And Fishback comes off the Auburn bench. Will come in at the next dead ball. 41-12. Auburn in front. Alexander from the corner missed everything. It's been that kind of first half.
Yes, it has. Alabama just doesn't have any emotion at all in this game, and just obviously don't have any confidence either, Bob. It's not playing well at all here.
And they played pretty well in recent history against Auburn. They've won 8 of the 9 matchups.
Yes, they have. They've had Auburn's number the last 5 or 6 years, but not today so far.
Shot clock is under 10. Brian Smith working against Thrasher. Pull-up jumper. That's off the mark, but look at the quick hands. Caldwell comes up with it. Inside to Smith. Well, he's got the advantage size-wise over Thrasher and throws it away. I think they wanted to post him up down low, but Smith just didn't take advantage of it. So the turnover gives it back to Alabama, but the Tide got a long road back, trailing 41-12 late in the first.
Company competition can't explain why they keep playing follow the leader. But then again, they've been doing it for so long, maybe it's just become habit forming. Ford Taurus. Now that explains everything. Have you driven a Ford lately?
If you're tired of eating food that comes in a box and ends up tasting like a box, come into Shoney's. Try our new hot and hearty soup and sandwich express lunch at a great low price. All the delicious home-style soup you want. Different choices every day, ready when you are. Plus your choice of four fresh made-to-order sandwiches, including Shoney's Slim Jim and Philly cheesesteak. Think outside the box. Try our new soup and sandwich express lunch today. Only at your Shoney's.
My mother taught me to be a real perfectionist, but around the house, I'm pretty relaxed. I think you should have beauty and comfort. So I looked in the real yellow pages from Bell South for a real comfy sofa and a real cozy rug. If it's called a living room, it should be lived in. No, no, don't sit on that.
Sorry.
No grape juice in here.
Sorry.
Like I said, relax.
Use the real yellow pages from Bell South.
March Madness begins with the SEC men's and women's basketball tournaments. Be there when the league's teams start their climb up the college basketball championship ladder. For ticket information, call the SEC's ticket office at 1-800-732-4849. Again, the men's tournament will be in Atlanta, the Georgia Dome, and the women's tournament this year for the first time in Columbus, Georgia, just up the road here from Auburn. Auburn leads today 41-12. Over Alabama. Joe, I don't think anybody really expected this.
I certainly didn't, Bob. This is very surprising. Auburn comes out of the timeout with a zone. That's Cliff Ellis's trademark, changing defenses. But I agree with you. I never would have thought that we'd have this kind of margin at this stage of the game.
Key stat, Auburn came into the game knowing it had to rebound against Alabama, out-rebounding the Tide 19-10. From the corner, no good. A shot and a foul as Fishback runs over Chauncey Jones, and so Fishback picks up his first foul. Three free throws now coming up for Chauncey Jones. And now Mamadou Njai comes back in. Brian Williams also back in for Alabama. There you see Demetrius Alexander.
Well, you see Jones, it looks like his foot was on the line, and Damian Fishback, you see a little scuffle there between Alexander and Chilius, nose to nose. They're going to go 15 tonight.
Jones hits the free toss. I'm not sure I'd want to tangle this chilliest.
Me either.
He's a big guy. Here's see Chauncey Jones out of Wabash Valley College, a junior college player out of Chicago. 1-for-2 at the line, and Pullman runs down the rebound. 41-13. Auburn in front with a basketball. Joe, one thing, Auburn, they've gotten right into their offense, haven't they?
They've run their offense crisply with a lot of hard cuts. Motion, no post players. They play good inside-out offense.
Pullman gives it over to the governor. Back to Pullman. He's fouled from the side. Chris Rollins got him. And so Pullman will go to the line.
What happens offensively when you have a lot of movement, a lot of player movement, you eliminate help defense from the defensive team, and consequently it opens up driving avenues and three-point baskets off those drives, which Auburn obviously has done well today. They're 7 of 8 from three-point range.
Coleman's a pretty good free throw shooter, 87%, but he missed that one. Cliff Ellis said he's a gym rat out of Roswell, Georgia. You always find him in the gym with a basketball. He missed them both. That's very unusual for him.
That's a major story right there.
So Alabama, one of the first breaks they've gotten in this game. Jones takes it and scores, and he's fouled and will go to the line. So Alabama, for the first time today, showing some sparks of life on offense. And they've cut the lead. It's 41-15.
Chauncey Jones is a very competitive young man, and he's taking matters into his own hands, attacking the basket on the dribble. Breakdown by the Auburn defense, going by a freshman right there, and laying it in. And that's the kind of spark and emotion you have to play with at this level to compete. Alabama has not done that here this afternoon.
Caldwell picks up the foul, and to the line goes Chauncey Jones again. And he hits that one. So Jones with four quick points. And it's 41-16. Alabama needs to close with a flurry here to get within striking distance for the second half. Bryan Smith trying to get rid of Thrasher. Can't do it. Alabama a little more aggressive now defensively. The governor gives it down low. Pullman, good cut, missed it. Njai puts it back up and draws the foul. Joe, one thing Auburn's been doing, and they showed it right there, they've been cutting very well without the basketball today.
They've been making hard cuts, playing well together, and ball movement has been excellent. Watch the penetration here in the motion offense and the pass, unselfish. That gets it on the glass. That opens up offensive rebound opportunities. Mamadou Njai in good position.
Njai, a 60% free throw shooter, steps up for a couple and gets that one. The announcers for the game are selected and compensated by Jefferson Pilot Sports. Any use of the broadcast without the express permission of the Southeastern Conference and Jefferson Pilot Sports is prohibited. Bob Kessling and Joe Dean with you today from Auburn, where Mamadou Njai hits two free throws to give the Tigers a 43-16 advantage. Under 3 minutes to go, first half. Alexander around Njai, but there to pick him up was Williams, and he causes the travel.
Alexander taking the ball and trying to go one-on-one, and we've seen a lot of that from Alabama today. Isolation plays, trying to establish one-on-one opportunities. Nice left-hand dribble right here, but great help by Franklin Williams coming across the lane, stopping that drive. That's a great shot of help defense that we talk about a lot in basketball.
It looked like Demetrius, when he made the turn there, he thought he was home free.
Exactly. But the help recognizes that. When your man is beat, you rotate over, shut down that drive, and that's great team defense by the governor out of Headland, Alabama, Franklin Williams.
Well, the most points Auburn has scored in a half this year is 50. They've got a chance to get it here. They need seven more in the last 2 minutes. And the ball stripped away, but Williams picks it back up. Plenty of time on the shot clock, 20 seconds. Njai open on the baseline. Jeremy Hayes back into the game, yanks off the rebound for Alabama. So the Tide gets a stop. Let's see if they can convert. Hayes, a 17-footer. One shot now for Alabama.
And not shooting with confidence. The coaching staff even mentioned that before the game, that the one thing the Alabama team needed to do was build some confidence in themselves. They've had a lot of close losses in the SEC season. They just don't really believe they can win right now, and boy, they're just not playing well at all here today.
Smith gets inside. He had Thrasher on him. That's a mismatch, and he picks up his 12th point.
And that's the job of a great small forward, a guy who can go inside and score on the post up, go outside and hit the three. Bryant Smith quickly becoming an all-SEC caliber small forward.
Hayes again. Misses again. And Caldwell can't tap dance on the sideline, and he steps out of bounds, so Alabama will get it at a fresh 35 seconds on the shot clock.
Bob, what happens to you when you start to shoot poorly, you begin to aim the ball at the basket. Jeremy Hayes right there looked like he was aiming the ball instead of catching it, going up in rhythm strong, and shooting his normal jump shot. And you're thinking about it. You want to create muscle memory in shooting the ball and not have to think about what you're doing.
Jeremy Hayes, 1-for-6 from the field. But lately, a lot of those are 15-footers. I'm sure they'd like him a little closer to the basket. 45-16, Auburn leading here on Wednesday night. Remember, an SEC East battle as the Tennessee Volunteers take on the South Carolina Gamecocks in Columbia. Our coverage starts at 8 o'clock Eastern, 7 o'clock Central Time. Check for the game in your area, Tennessee against South Carolina.
Telling statistic, Bob, in the first half. 52 seconds to go here at halftime. Alabama does not have an assist in this game, and they have 8 turnovers. That says it all right there.
Baseline gets in low. Alexander has the ball slapped away, and it bounces off the foot of Williams. And Cliff Ellis, he was pleading his case, and there's an overrule, and the ball goes back. Auburn. Cliff did a good job that time running down the sideline.
Did a great job over there. Cliff Ellis done a great, excellent job here bringing this Auburn program along. 3 straight winning seasons. Looks like he's going to have his 4th straight winning season this year. Has built successful programs everywhere he's been. South Alabama, Clemson, and now trying to do it at Auburn.
There's a 5-second differential on the shot clock, so Auburn will have to shoot it now. Now that changes now because the foul on Alabama. And that's going to be a 1-and-1 opportunity now for the Auburn Tigers. The foul is on Bacote, his first. And to the line goes Brian Smith. It's been a tough season of late for David Hobbs, and this has been a tough game to watch in the first half for his Crimson Tide.
Well, a lot of people know that David Hobbs' father-in-law was killed tragically a couple of weeks ago. Our thoughts and prayers go out to the family, Skeet, his wife, and their family in that situation. And, of course, Kermit Koenig, the assistant coach at Alabama under David Hobbs, has undergone some cancer therapy. Been a tough year, Bob. You're right.
Yeah. Ball sails out of bounds. It'll be Auburn's basketball with 6 seconds to go.
And shooting like that from his players doesn't make it any easier.
3 seconds to go. Pullman launches. No good. Tip is no good, and the half is over. A nightmarish first half for the Alabama Crimson Tide, but the Auburn Tigers came out red hot and stayed that way. Auburn leads at halftime, 45-16. Our halftime activities start from the plains in just a moment.
SEC basketball is brought to you by BP. At BP, everything we do is to keep you moving. By Jameson Inn, where you're guaranteed a perfect stay every time. And by Bell South. Bell South is proud to be the official telecommunications partner of the SEC.
At Jameson Inn, every day in every detail, from our free continental breakfast to the way we say hello, we're different because we're not a franchise. So we have only one way of doing things, the right way. That's why when you check into a Jameson Inn, I guarantee you a perfect stay every time. I'm Tom Kitchen, CEO of Jameson Inns, and that's a promise.
BP shops. P.S. We've sent your letter to engineering. Prepay cards from BP are now available and make great gifts.
Advance Auto Parts presents part number 6, Ed from purchasing. At an early age, Ed gained an appreciation for low prices.
Yes, Edward.
If you buy a whole lot of stuff, you can sell it for a whole lot less.
Good, Edward. Good.
High-volume buying is how Ed keeps prices low for you.
No, that's zillion with a Z, not trillion with a T.
Advance Auto Parts. The best part is our people.
SEC basketball is brought to you in part by Advance Auto Parts. The best part is our people.
Our Reese's SEC Play of the Week is brought to you by Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. No wrong way to eat a Reese's and no wrong way to make an alley-oop. Just ask B.J. Mackey of South Carolina. He finds high-flying Herbert Lee Davis for the jam. What about Vanderbilt's Drew Maddox? Finds Billy DeSpaltro. And finally, Brian Williams of Alabama hits Neil Ashby for the Rim Rocker. And that's our Reese's SEC Play of the Week. Halftime in Auburn, Alabama. The Tigers all over the Crimson Tide, 45-16. Bob Kessling and Joe Dean, welcome to halftime, everybody. And this is an Auburn basketball team that just had a terrific first half.
Bob, they played unbelievable and shot the ball extremely well. 7 out of 9 from three-point range. They actually had one more three-point basket than Alabama had all field goals. Alabama had only 6. And no assists, and we talked about that. That's unbelievable that you'd go a whole half without an assist, but that basically tells the story of Alabama's first half.
Every half we pick a hot hand for Auburn. That's kind of tough to do. But one of the inspirational leaders today was the governor, Franklin Williams.
Well, this is a quality young man. He's in graduate school from Headland, Alabama. They call him the governor. You see, of course, that's Doc Robinson right there. Mamadou Njai, great rebound there by Franklin, and he throws it out to Doc Robinson, a sophomore out of Selma, Alabama, with the hot hand.
So you looked at all of them, you mentioned Bryant Smith with 12 points in the first half. Just everybody contributed to this Auburn big lead here at halftime.
They do, but you know, a lot of times a team reflects its best player. Bryant Smith is the leading scorer for Auburn in the first half. He's made threes, he's scored inside, he's defended, he's gotten offensive rebounds, and the rest of the team just really feeds off of his energy. Bryant Smith, an excellent player out of Huntsville.
Special trophy presentation being made here at halftime as Terry Bowden, the Auburn football coach here, ODK, one of the fraternities here on campus, they have a trophy every year they present for the Iron Bowl. The winner of the game between Auburn and Alabama gets to keep the trophy. And so Coach Terry Bowden is here on behalf of the Auburn football team to get the ODK trophy. And of course, Terry Bowden and the Tigers had another big season. Went to a bowl game this year and won the bowl game, and his Tigers, of course, won the Iron Bowl. So here, they won the football game. They're winning the basketball game in convincing style, 45-16. We'll continue at halftime in just a moment.
Dear BP, what if you had special trucks that could turn into gas stations? Then we could buy what we need and get to where we're going a lot faster. Signed, Dan.
Dear Dan, we keep people moving with pay at the pump and our fast BP shops. P.S. We've sent your letter to engineering. Prepay cards from BP are now available and make great gifts.
Of gallons of motor oil are poured down drains, dumped on the ground, and tossed into landfills. It's a crying shame for the environment and for everybody in it. That's why Advance Auto Parts provides free oil recycling at every store 7 days a week. Bring your used motor oil to Advance and make the future a cleaner, safer, happier place for all of us.
DQ chicken fingers are the greatest. No skin, no bones. Delicious, tender, and golden brown. The chicken finger snack is on special all this month. Three marinated and freshly breaded strips of breast with fries and a roll. Take the whole family to Dairy Queen and attack a snack.
Hot eat, cool treat. We treat you right.
Be sure to visit the official internet site of the Southeastern Conference for up-to-date stats, game previews, coaches' comments, and much, much more. The SEC online at secsports.com, the official internet site of the SEC. 45-16 is the score here at Auburn. And now here's a look at our Jefferson Pilot scoreboard from yesterday. LSU, a big win on the road. They almost won at Arkansas. Pulled off a big win yesterday at Florida. Vanderbilt wins at home against Mississippi State, 77-73. Kentucky needed overtime to beat the Arkansas Razorbacks in a terrific game yesterday in Lexington, 80-77. And a big win last night for Tennessee at home, knocking off the 11th-ranked Ole Miss Rebels, 77-67. Joe, you were at that game last night. Big win for Jerry Green's crew.
Really was, Bob. Tennessee played extremely well and beat a very good Ole Miss team. Kentucky's win over Arkansas big because it sets up Kentucky maybe to run away with the East. They got to be careful there. And the win by LSU at Gainesville was big. That's their first win on the road in over 2 years. John Brady doing a fine job at LSU.
So here's a look at the standings. Kentucky, the only team undefeated in the East. Vanderbilt, South Carolina, two games back. And then the Florida Gators. And, of course, the dog race over in the West now between Ole Miss and Arkansas. And there's Auburn. If the Tigers stay the course here today, they will be tied with the Rebels and the Razorbacks. And LSU, only 2-3. They played very well. Mississippi State, I guess, Joe, a bit of a surprise at 1-3.
Well, Mississippi State has had some tough games. They've played Kentucky, and they've had a couple games on the road at Arkansas and Vanderbilt. But I think they'll be back. As you see, scoreboard, Indiana over Purdue, 94-88. Big win for Bob Knight in the rival game up in the Hoosier Land. Syracuse over Miami, 85-67.
NC State and Virginia in the second. They're tied at 51. And coming up in a few minutes, South Carolina and Georgia down in Athens. A big game for both of those teams. So that's a look at our Jefferson Pilot Sports Scoreboard here at halftime. Auburn on top of Alabama. 45-16 as Auburn keeps the ODK trophy. Back with more in just a moment.
Bell South presents You Call the Play. Last season, tied at 62, Vanderbilt and Ole Miss went to the wire. Following an offensive rebound, Vandy calls timeout with 12.4 seconds left. Who do you go to win the game? Do you kick it inside to the big men, get it to your hot hand, or go with a senior to take the game-winning shot? What did Coach Jan Van Bredekoff do? You call the play.
This isn't just a car. It's a sign of how far you've come. So if it gets damaged, who do you want on your side? At Nationwide Insurance, we guarantee that your car will be fixed just the way it should be. Because we wouldn't have it any other way.
Nationwide is on your side.
At Valvoline, we work hard to achieve high performance. It's what you would expect from our products and our people. High performance is why Valvoline is the number one choice of top mechanics for use in their own cars and trucks. We're proud of our association with the great schools of the Southeastern Conference because the SEC shares our commitment to high performance in athletics and in education. Take a spin around the SEC. You'll find high performance every day.
All of us at Dr. Pepper are extremely proud of our association with the Southeastern Conference and the Southeastern Conference's unique tradition of academic and athletic excellence. Dr. Pepper is pleased to provide support for the many positive educational and athletic programs of the 12-member institution and the Southeastern Conference Football Championship.
Dr. Pepper, the official soft drink of the SEC Football Championship and proud sponsor of the Southeastern Conference.
Is there anything more heartwarming than the day a son comes to work for his father?
I don't even want to be in this stupid business.
Oh, that's right. You want to be an author.
You see what he does, Tyler? Just because I
you
want
know,
to write...
I was thinking. You guys could sell a ton more inventory if you use the internet. And all you got to do is write up a little catalog page like that.
So?
So you can write it. Each one of these clubs has got to tell a story, right?
Jerry vigorously grasped the driver in his hands.
Of course, you don't have to do it, you know, right now.
Vandy went to the senior who may have shot too soon. He misfired. Ole Miss rebounds with time to play. They push it up court and hit the jumper for the 64-62 win. You call the play. A presentation of Bell South.
Auburn Tigers back out on the floor. Alabama still meeting with David Hobbs in the locker room to iron out some things before the second half starts. With the Tigers in front, 45-16. Bob Kessling and Joe Dean at halftime. A couple of things stand out. One, Auburn won the battle of the boards, and also Auburn only turned it over four times, and they shot brilliantly.
Well, they did. The shooting was the key, and of course, you look for effort, and when you look for effort, you look at turnovers your defense creates, and you look at rebounding. Auburn has had the best in both of those statistics.
Let's look at some of the first half highlights, and the highlights, the outstanding shooting of the Auburn Tigers, 54%.
Well, it comes from inside out. We've talked about that. Fishback finishes off the Bryant Smith assist. And he's lit it up in the first half as he did a week ago down in Baton Rouge. And again, same scenario. Smith inside out. Fishback plays a little string music.
And they had 7 of 9 3-point shots. Alabama, on the other hand, only 22% from the field. They just couldn't get it going.
Well, there's an example, the air ball by Demetrius Alexander, and you see the shooting percentages. That basically says it all.
It's time for the Jefferson Pilot Sports halftime stats. Joe mentioned the shooting percentages, and you see the outstanding three-point effort by Auburn. They hit their first seven and missed their last two, 7 of 9. But the rebounding is the thing I'm sure that Cliff Ellis is most proud of.
He really is, because that's a sign of intensity and effort. Auburn had it here in the first half, and Alabama did not.
So the Tigers, it's been raining threes at Auburn. Second half coming up with the Tigers in control of the Crimson Tide. Get things started in the second half in a moment.
As the creator of Premier Telecommunications Customer Care and Billing Systems and the operator of our own highly successful communications company, we help firms worldwide deliver the service their customers demand. Alltel, always more than you thought.
Everyone needs someone who will be there. Everyone needs someone on their side.
If your car or home is damaged, your Nationwide insurance agent will be there, making sure your property is repaired or replaced to your complete satisfaction, with no hassles. That's our Blue Ribbon Claims Guarantee.
Nationwide is on your side.
Even today, it's almost like I can hear Denny Chimes. I remember how proud I was to be a student at the University of Alabama. The capstone is still calling me. The Alumni Association is my way to answer, my way to give something back.
Communications, information services. The faster these technologies converge, the sooner we need to talk. Alltel, always more than you thought.
Do you know anything about this crime?
On the afternoon of December 27th, the manager of the Easy Serve convenience store on Norman Bridge Road was taking a deposit to the bank. A lone male snuck up behind her, struggled with her as she entered the car, and grabbed the money. He then sped off in a blue and white Chevy Cavalier.
If you have any information that might help solve this crime, call 215-STOP. Watch Targeting Crime, Crime Stoppers, Wednesday on the 10 o'clock report.
Jefferson Pilot Sports' exclusive presentation of SEC basketball is being brought to you by Alltel, where computing and communications converge. Alltel, always more than you thought. And by Nationwide Insurance. Check the yellow pages for the Nationwide agent nearest you.
Tigers have had a lot of fun here in the first half, leading Alabama 45-16. Second half getting set to go. Joe, the leading scorer for Alabama, has 4 points, and there's only one player in double figures, so that shows you that Auburn has had balanced scoring.
Well, Auburn has, and Bryant Smith has led the way with 12. Franklin Williams with 9 points, and he really wanted to play well today, Bob, because he knew that Randy Hughes was out today, that he was going to be called on to do more, and the governor has really responded this afternoon.
Well, let's see how Alabama responds to the halftime chat they had with David Hobbs.
Auburn has started in a triangle and two. Doc Robinson chases Chauncey Jones, and Bryant Smith chasing Brian Williams.
Jones on the baseline, and Alabama scores its first possession.
Well, that's not supposed to happen against a triangle and two, where one of the guys you're chasing actually takes it in and shoots a layup against the zone.
Doc Robinson finds a seam, missed it. N'Jai puts it back in.
N'Jai's been all over the board this afternoon. Exposed himself well, gets in there, has good quickness and speed for a guy that's 7 feet tall.
Hayes gets loose underneath, gets fouled, and will go to the basket. So Alabama, much more active offensively, at least in the first two trips.
Trying to take the ball inside and attack the goal. And that's what you've got to do a lot of, especially when you're behind. Watch N'Jai here on the follow. He just gets to the offensive board. The drive made it possible because Jeremy Hayes had to leave N'Jai to come help on the drive.
That's the second foul on Franklin Williams. And at the line is Jeremy Hayes, and he short arms that one a bit. Usually a pretty good free throw shooter. You see 74% on the season.
He's thinking too much today about his shooting. You watch him. He looks like he's trying to aim the ball into the basket.
And Hayes missed that one, and Williams gets the rebound. Alabama at this point in time needs to connect on every point it can. Everyone's viable to get them back in this game. Alexander pokes it free. Both players dive on the floor. Now it pops out of there, and Brian Williams picks it up. So Alabama's defense, credit Demetrius Alexander for the turnover. Joe, now it's just execution for Alabama, isn't it?
Trying to run some sets and see if you can get the ball down low or attack the goal to try to put yourself in a position to get to the free throw line.
Hayes inside, puts it up and in.
Well, that's the best set they've run, Bob, right there. They set up a high-low situation with Alexander high and Jeremy Hayes down low. Alexander with a nice pass and Hayes with the finish.
Alabama tried that early in the game. It didn't work, and they got away from it, and that got buried. Now they're trying to go back to it. Counts on. Smith gets rid of it to Williams.
We talked a lot about the fact that Alabama did not have an assist in the first half. That was the first assist in the game that came from Demetrius Alexander.
Shot clock at 5. At 4, Robinson has to force it. No good. Njai active inside. Missed the putback. Gets it on the third try.
Well, he wanted an extra rebound. He actually got 2 rebounds there because he missed that first shot attempt.
49-20. Hayes again is open inside and missed it. That's on the layup.
What can you say?
You can't execute any better than that. Pullman makes him pay a 3.
Now that sequence right there just tells the tale of the game today. Jeremy Hayes misses an easy layup, and Scott Pullman at the other end with a 3-point basket.
5-point turnaround just like that. Jones dribbled it off a foot, but a foul is called. Holding foul on Auburn. It'll be on Scott Pullman.
Well, here's the high-low setup we talked about. Nice pass by Demetrius Alexander and a good finish by 6'10 sophomore Jeremy Hayes. And then watch Njai on the offensive rebound. Misses the first one. He says, I'm going to get another rebound. He actually gets credit for that rebound there. 2 rebounds in that sequence in the putback.
So he helped his scoring average and he helped his rebounding average all on the same trip.
11 points and 8 rebounds today from Amadou Njai. Really looks like a heck of a force inside. Much improved.
Shot clock at 10. Jones in the corner. Lost it. Gets it to Alexander. I'm not sure the ball slipped out of his hands or not, but it worked out well for Alabama.
Well, Auburn has been in that triangle in 2, and the zone in the lane has not done a good job of protecting against the inside people. Alabama's gotten in there now 3 times against this defense.
Robinson off a pick and hits.
That's what Doc Robinson does so well. Off the dribble, pull up and shoot the mid-range jump shot. He's very effective with that.
That pass is intercepted inside by Njai. They saw it coming, and now Brian Williams trying to get it back. A holding foul on him. 10th turnover for Alabama. So Auburn maintains the lead as the Tigers lead the Crimson Tide 54-22 early in the second.
As computing and communications converge, Alltel's practical approach and proven solutions can take your company to a new level faster than you ever dreamed. Alltel, always more than you thought.
This isn't just a car. It's a sign of how far you've come. So if it gets damaged, who do you want on your side? At Nationwide Insurance, we guarantee that your car will be fixed just the way it should be. Because we wouldn't have it any other way.
Nationwide is on your side.
Communications. Information services. The faster these technologies converge, the sooner we need to talk. Alltel. Always more than you thought.
Big stars, big fun in the Big Easy. The Gail King Show from New Orleans. First, best-selling author Anne Rice shows us the dark side of her hometown. Then, Gail gets a cooking lesson from world-renowned chef Paul Prudhomme.
You take that out, I think we
take it out. Voila.
Beautiful.
Gothic novelist Anne Rice and a famous chef, that would be Paul Prudhomme, show us their side of New Orleans on the next Gail King Show.
Weekday mornings at 9:30 on WSFA.
Coming up this Saturday, an SEC doubleheader here on Jefferson Pilot Sports. The Florida Gators taking on Drew Maddox and the Vanderbilt Commodores. That's 1 o'clock Eastern, 12 o'clock Central Time. Following that game, we'll be right back here at Auburn when the South Carolina Gamecocks come in to take on the Auburn Tigers. Melvin Watson against Doc Robinson and company. So again, a doubleheader next week. The second game, South Carolina and Auburn, and Florida and Vanderbilt. In the first game, check your local listings for the station in your area carrying SEC basketball here on Jefferson Pilot Sports. Bob Kessling and Joe Dean, along with our producer Scott Snyder, director Dave Perchett, and the rest of our Jefferson Pilot crew here today in amongst the Cliff Dwellers there.
Cliff Dwellers are fired up this afternoon. They came in here charged up. Anytime Auburn and Alabama get together, a lot of emotion.
Alabama didn't answer the emotional charge today. Franklin Williams taking it to the basket and draws the foul.
Alabama foul, number 34, Chris Ross.
Cliff Ellis' motion offense has really been effective today. Five men moving all the time has opened up these kind of drives, and Franklin Williams, the senior graduate student, takes it to the goal.
He's got an outside shot to get to 1,000 points this year now. He's at 910 in his career. He's got to hit those to get there.
Quality young man, graduated early in grad school, as we mentioned. His brother, Sammy Jackson, is an assistant coach at Georgia Southern University.
So Governor is in double figures with 10, and it's 55-22.
Auburn now, excuse me, Bob, goes out of the triangle and two to a 1-3-1.
Big coach takes it in, maybe got away with an extra step, but gets it to go, his first basket.
Definitely got away with a walk, but a good move down the baseline by Damon Baycoat.
Joe, if you're Auburn, do you kind of use some clock now, or do you keep running your offense?
No, I think you just keep doing what you're doing, Bob. They're playing so well, they're in sync. And you just keep pushing the ball, run your motion offense, and take what the defense will give you inside or out.
They got a good shot at that time. Didn't fall for Cliff Ellis. See, he's had his troubles against Alabama, but not today. David Hobbs, on the other hand, 5-1 all time against Cliff Ellis. Brian Williams thought about the three, doesn't take it. If you're Alabama, Joe, when do you start watching?
Well, I think now. I mean, you've got to try to do something to get yourself back in the game and to get some excitement on with your team. That's the thing I'm disappointed with Alabama today. They're not playing with much emotion.
There's an emotional block, but it goes right back to Auburn, and Brian Smith gets it.
You know, and again, case in point for Alabama, they make one good play, but they can't sustain it and finish the play, and that's been their problem all year, especially in SEC play, not finishing games and winning at the end.
Alfred Moss into the game, the freshman out of Newman, Georgia, and he gets the bucket. And so, again, David Hobbs looking for different combinations, trying to find a spark here. Good looking, low, chilliest, and he's going to be bumped and fouled from behind. Moss gets it. That'll be his first.
Well, let's see the block by Alabama right here. You see Alfred Moss, freshman, great leaping ability. He knocks it away from Doc Robinson, but Brian Smith, always the active player around the basket. Brian Smith with the follow.
Pullman off a pick, comes up firing, doesn't get the bounce. Look at Auburn run it down again. And a whistle and a pushing foul as the Governor almost got shoved into the bench. Foul on Alabama.
Auburn has beat Alabama to the loose balls all afternoon. They've really come to play, been well prepared by Cliff Ellis and his staff, and I have to admire him. You know, Randy Hughes has been one of the big players for Auburn. Got into some trouble over the weekend. Cliff Ellis has suspended him. Said it's a team rule. He hated it, but just like a father with his son, you have to discipline guys, especially when they're young. But the rest of the players, especially Franklin Williams, have stepped up and made things happen.
Nice move by Brian Smith. 16 points for him, the SEC Player of the Week. Alabama in the first half was 6 of 27 from the field. This half, they're 5 of 6, but they're not making up a whole lot of ground here. Shot blocked by Chilius and a foul. Bacot got hacked, and Chilius picks up his third.
Chilius is a big, strong guy. He's a little bit foul-prone, but he's played a big role here today, as we mentioned, with Hughes out. So let's see if we can see that. Looked like a pretty good block, but I think he got Bacot on the arm.
Bacot at the line, and an 8-game streak of double-figure scoring snapped the other night against Vanderbilt when they only had 4 points. Today, gunning for his third point of the day. And you see the boards. Boy, Auburn has just dominated.
14 offensive rebounds lead to 21 easy points. I tell you, that's what every coach is looking for with his team. Give us easy baskets, easy points. Offensive rebounds does that.
Alabama tries to press, but Auburn breaks it easily and now sets up the offense, leading 59-28. The hands of Franklin Williams out of bounds, and so Alabama gets it back, a rare Auburn turnover.
You can see what Auburn's trying to do offensively: spread the floor, drive the gaps of the defense, pitch out, drive the floor, and find open people off the dribble. They're keeping the lane open, and today Cliff Ellis's offense has been very effective.
Doesn't get much easier for Alabama. Their next game is at Kentucky, then they go to Arkansas, and then finally home against Tennessee. It's a pretty tough stretch of 3 games on the road. Shot from the corner is good by Bacot.
Yeah, this will be the toughest week of the year for the Alabama basketball team. Coming off of this game here, if it holds up the way it looks, to get ready to go play in Lexington and in Fayetteville, Alabama coaching staff will have their work cut out for them this week.
Jones picks up the foul. And you talk about the schedule for David Hobbs. February, they have a couple of some home games coming up, but he knew going in, I think, if they could survive January, they have a pretty good shot. So far, they're kind of treading water.
Yeah, they lost some tough games. Early game against Mississippi State at home, they lost a heartbreaker last Wednesday to Vanderbilt, a very good Vanderbilt team by 3 points. Just have not been able to close the deal and win close games this year.
Njai down low, gets mugged and will go to the line. Hard foul down low, and Mamadou will go to the stripe. The foul is on Alfred Moss, his second. They weren't going to give up an easy layup.
Mamadou with a good drop step again, lunging to the basket and putting pressure on the defense. Nice move by the 7-foot sophomore. He has 2 more years and is continuing to get better and better each game out.
Speaks, what, 3 different languages, huh?
Very intelligent young man. You're right, Bob. He is an excellent student, taking some hard classes here at Auburn. And he's a quick learner in basketball. And the Auburn staff has really been impressed with how quickly he picks things up and applies it to his game on the floor.
They're originally a soccer player. They threw the ball away. And then suddenly they starts playing basketball.
There was another big soccer player that came out of, I think, Nigeria. What was his name? Starts with an O.
The guy that's playing with the Rockets, I believe.
Olajuwon, that's it.
Hakeem, yeah, he was a pretty good soccer player, too. I think he's making a little more money basketball than he would have in soccer. Pass inside, Moss knocks it away. They tried to post up Njai. Moss and Njai are going at it pretty good inside.
Good job by Moss that time to get over the top of the post player. Deny the pass inside.
Well, I think, Joe, right now, you being a former coach, you know that this is the time when coaches are looking at, hey, who's going to step up, who's going to keep playing hard, and those are the guys I'm going to hang my hats on the rest of the year.
Exactly, Bob. You want to find guys that will compete. He's got Tariq London in right now, a freshman, got some young players. Just want to see somebody battle right now and show some pride in themselves as an athlete.
Coleman, a good shooter outside, missed that one. Njai now going to be called for a foul in low. He and Moss have been going at it pretty good.
Yeah, Alfred Moss has done a good job here in the time that he's in. He's trying to show David Hobbs that he deserves some more playing time. Battling Mamadou Njai, who's had a nice ball game this afternoon.
Well, 12 minutes to go, and Alabama's down 31. They can't waste a lot of time now. running their offensive patterns. They got to get some shots in the air.
If you'd have told me that before the game, that Alabama, or Auburn, I should say, would be up by 31 in the second half, I'd have said no way. Very surprised by this score.
There's the three. That won't stay down. Alabama battling, but the ball comes out to Scott Pullman. Mamadou thought about it, didn't take it. Alabama still 0 for 7 on the day from three-point range. Robinson. Oh, he got the roll.
Well, as our partner Tim Brando would say, the iron was kind.
Very kind on that one. His second three-point shot of the day. 64 to 30. Pullman picks it free. Mamadou running the break. Back to Doc Robinson, who gets it and gets fouled. Mamadou running the fast break at 7 foot. Picks up the assist to Doc Robinson, who draws the foul.
Mamadou Indjah playing a little Magic Johnson on the break. And watch the finish. Doc Robinson between two Alabama defenders. Circus shot. Let's look at it again. Nice feed, two on one. Incredible finish. Sophomore out of Selma, Alabama, Doc Robinson.
You know, I thought at first he was going to give it back to Mamadou, but I don't think it wasn't a clear pass, so he just took it himself. But a great play by Auburn on the break at 66 to 30. And things aren't getting any better for Alabama. Another turnover, and here comes Auburn again. Doc Robinson lets it fly. What about that?
Unbelievable. That young man is really starting to come into his own. Doc Robinson lighting it up today at Auburn.
Auburn is 10 now of 13 from three-point range. The lead, unbelievably enough, is 39. Doc Robinson with 15 points for the surging Tigers.
Some people know us as their phone company. Others know us as their wireless service provider. Still, others rely on our paging services and internet access. As a Forbes 500 company with over 80 years in the communications business, we do all of those things. But we also provide information-based solutions to customers in 45 countries with our leading-edge software, management services, and technical expertise. Alltel. Always more than you thought.
This week's Advance Auto Parts Rookie of the Week in the SEC is Alabama junior Chauncey Jones. On the season, he's been a major contributor to the Tide attack. He ranks fourth in scoring in Alabama and leads the Tide in minutes, steals, and assists. Quite a feat for a newcomer to the SEC. He comes to Alabama after 2 years at Wabash Valley College. And that's the Crimson Tide's Chauncey Jones, this week's Advance Auto Parts Rookie of the Week.
What makes a Dairy Queen frozen birthday cake so special? First of all, it's made with lots and lots of delicious Dairy Queen chocolate and vanilla soft serve. Everybody's favorite. Plus, there's a layer of chocolate fudge and chocolate crunch. But the icing on the cake is you can get it decorated our way or your way. The Dairy Queen birthday cake. There is no other birthday cake quite like it. We treat you right. Dairy Queen.
Our Nationwide Insurance Scholar Athlete of the Week is Alabama's Jeremy Hayes. The sophomore center from Boaz, Alabama, has a 3.2 GPA in business. Congratulations to Jeremy Hayes, our Nationwide Insurance Scholar Athlete of the Week. Jeremy with 4 points this afternoon, as Alabama has struggled for scoring all day long. And the Crimson Tide being walloped right now by Auburn, 69 to 30. There you see, Auburn has tied a record for three-pointers this season with 10 of those. They've only hit 89 on the season, and they've got 10 today. Well, that puts them up to 99. They had 89 coming into the game.
Free shooting today, playing with a lot of confidence. They hit them early, and they've continued to make them. Now they're back zone, straight zone.
Shot clock is to 10 now for Alabama. Almost another steal, but Williams gets it back. Now he's got to do something with it. 5 seconds. London kicks it off. Hayes. Won't go down, and Ninjai rebounds. 1-for-7 now from the field for Hayes in the game. And Auburn's got a chance to build the lead to over 40. The governor. No good. Ball's loose on the floor. Bryant Smith got it. Lost it. And goes out of bounds. But no, he called timeout. Timeout. 30-second timeout by Bryant Smith. Joe, the way things are going, every time Auburn throws up good, bad, and different shot, you think it's going to go in.
You do, and when you're ahead by 39 points, you have unbelievable confidence. You think everything you shoot's going to go in. There's no pressure. So these Auburn players are really feeling it. And Cliff Ellis has done a great job getting his team ready for today, what was a big game for them coming in here, trying to tie Arkansas and Ole Miss for first place in the West.
Now it's time for our Altel play of the game. And, of course, you might figure it involves the Auburn Tigers and their new point guard, the seven-footer, Mamadou Njai. He comes up with the loose ball and looks like Magic Man.
He played a little Magic Johnson there on the break. He has great speed. Mamadou to Doc Robinson. That was a nice play for Auburn.
So that's our all-tell play of the game. 9:53 to go here at Auburn. And the Tigers lead at 69-30. Doc can't get it in. Calls another timeout. So another 20-second timeout. The Tigers have to burn it. Scoring in the game, Bryant Smith has 16 for Auburn. Mamadou Njai with 13. Franklin Williams with 10. Doc Robinson with 15 in the game. So balanced scoring for those Tiger starters. 4 in double figures. And Alabama still looking for their first player in double figures today.
Not much you can say right now, Bob. We're trying to find things to talk about here, but, you know, great game for Auburn so far. Tough day for that man right there, David Hobbs.
Under 10 minutes to go. Derek Caldwell back into the game, so he's trying to set something up. 20 seconds on the shot clock.
Good player movement, good ball movement today by Auburn in their offense.
They've gotten everybody involved. Robinson, a floater, no good.
Look at that. That's unbelievable. I tell you what, that guy a year ago could have not done that. Great rebound off the move and to go up with a left-handed scoop shot. Mamadou Njai really coming into his own.
The lead is 41 for Auburn. In some games where Auburn's had problems scoring 41 points. Reverse layup, no good. Nothing going for Alabama. Out of bounds. And the ball will stay with the Alabama Crimson Tide.
Let's see this. Doc Robinson on the drive. Watch Mamadou Njai come out of nowhere and pull it in with his left hand. Go back up and use the left to shoot the shot. That is absolutely sensational.
Alabama with the basketball. Njai, by the way, now a double-double, 15 points, 10 rebounds. Moss comes up firing. Another deflection by Njai. Goes to Fishback. Now a whistle and a holding foul. Can be called on Blake Thrasher.
David Dodge told Blake Thrasher right there, don't do that. Grabbed him on the cut.
Second foul on Blake. It's the 8th team foul of Alabama this half, and so Fishback goes to the line.
Damian Fishback to the line for the Tigers.
Damian Fishback's father, Charlie Fishback, was a star player at Cumberland Junior College in Lebanon, Tennessee, and was coached by Cliff Ellis way back when. Finished his career at Austin Peay and was an all-OVC player there. And now young Damian has come to Auburn to play for Cliff Ellis. He was Mr. Basketball in the state of Kentucky his senior year of high school.
He's kind of been in a bit of a funk, though, hasn't he?
He has not shot the ball well this year. Shot well last Wednesday at Baton Rouge, and then today he shot well. So hopefully for Damian Fishback, he's starting to come out of it.
Mamadou! Boy, that was almost spectacular. Mamadou had a chance to bring the goal down, but passed just a little bit high by Pullman.
Scotty Pullman's laughing when you're up by 41, you can laugh when you make a mistake like that, and the coach won't get mad at you. This guy here has had a tough day, Bob. Brian Williams, Alabama's leading scorer.
2 for 9 from the field, and an offensive foul on him as he drives through. And it runs over Franklin Williams, who might have got a Golden Globe for that performance there.
He has struggled a lot this year. His shooting has not been good. His turnover assist ratio is not good. Right here you see him charge Franklin Williams. Great job of stepping in and taking the charge. But Brian just not having one of those seasons that Alabama needs for him to have to give them a chance to be a good basketball team.
Neither team could get any points lately. And now Alabama gets the ball back, trailing by 41 points. Moss goes inside and draws the foul. So Moss has really made some things happen since he's coming here in the second half, getting some valuable minutes.
Out of Noonan, Georgia, which is just up I-85 from here in Auburn. And he has done well. He's a good athlete, about 6'6", 210-pound freshman. And David Hobbs giving him some good playing time here this afternoon on JP.
That's right. He had 6 field goals for the season coming in today. He has 1 and this afternoon. 2 of 4 at the line coming in, and that's his 5th miss. He's now 2 of 5 on the season, but a good-looking young man, 210 freshman. They'll put some weight on him during the offseason in the weight room.
Sometimes poor shooting is contagious. It has been for Alabama today. You see another miss there, and likewise for Auburn on the positive side.
We mentioned the Alabama schedule coming up. It's kind of difficult for Auburn as well. They have Arkansas coming in, then South Carolina next week. Then they go to Mississippi State, and Ole Miss comes in here. So some home games, but tough ones coming up for the Auburn Tigers.
Opportunity games for Auburn next week. They've got both home games against 2 nationally ranked teams and a chance to see if Auburn is for real in the SEC West.
Caldwell gets that one to go. He's got 5 points on the afternoon.
He had 25 against Alabama a year ago. Derek Caldwell, another in the long line of Auburn players from Brantley, Alabama. And as I said earlier, that Brantley High School team is here today.
Moss inside, whistle, double dribble is called. As Alfred Moss got in a lot of traffic inside and couldn't get the shot up. So Auburn gets the ball back in full control of this one, 73-30 over our rival Alabama.
Never before has your competitiveness relied so heavily on networking and communications technology. With markets expanding around the world and customers demanding immediate access, Alltel stands out as offering total business solutions customized to meet your needs. Wide area video and data networking. Call centers offering your computing capabilities directly to your customers. Alltel delivers complete communications and computing solutions. Alltel, always more than you thought.
Advance Auto Parts presents part number 42. Jesse from Quality Control. Jesse travels the country. He spans the globe in search of the best quality parts for your car. Factory visits.
Alle Teile übertreffen die Spezifikationen des Herstellers.
Wunderbar. Product inspections on over 250,000 different parts and accessories.
Thank you.
No problem.
Advance Auto Parts. The best part is our people.
Expedition, the only way to get there.
Auburn convincingly out in front right now, 73-30 over the Alabama Crimson Tide. Auburn with a win ties for first place in the SEC West.
Well, we talked about the Brantley connection. That's Tony Stallworth. He's the high school coach at Brantley High School. Of course, they've produced some great ones here at Auburn. The Person brothers, Chuck and Wesley, Aubrey Wiley, and now Derek Caldwell, and at some of the Brantley High School basketball team enjoying this action here today.
They've seen a show by this Auburn basketball team this afternoon. 7:21 to go. Ah. Coleman in front court for Auburn as Alabama stays in the man-to-man.
Go!
Clock down to 7 minutes. Fishback the launch. How about that?
How sweet it is, huh? Fishback is back. Been in a slump early, but last two games he's shot the ball very well for Auburn.
Auburn on a 16-0 run. They built the lead to 76-30. It was 59-30. So actually 17-0 run.
Alabama has not scored in almost 7 minutes of this second half. Unbelievable.
There's a steal by Caldwell.
Right on cue out of Brantley, Alabama. The Brantley faithful loves that, Derek Caldwell.
So now it's a 19-0 run, the ball out of bounds.
Derek Caldwell was an outstanding football prospect coming out of Brantley High School. There was some talk that he might try to play football at Auburn. You've talked about the football players coming to the basketball team. And this young man is just a good all-around athlete, about 6'4", runs, jumps, shoots the ball well, and a tremendous person, fine young man.
And he's up to scoring average a bit, came in averaging 4 points a game. He's got 7 today. Mamadou Njai goes out with a 15 points and 11 rebounds. The 11 rebounds, a career high. His high career for points is 18. Thrasher's open. That won't go. Ball loose. Baycoat has it. Finds Jeremy Hayes. Now Brian Williams. That's off the mark. Hayes lost it out of bounds. Auburn gets it. Joe, this has been just a game in which Alabama has just not been able to do anything right offensively.
No, they haven't. Every team has a game like this, Bob, albeit maybe not this bad, but every team has a game where just nothing goes right. And I know it's disappointing for David Hobbs and his staff because the Alabama team has not shown much emotion today and just hasn't played very hard.
Fishback, fall away, got it again. And it also looks even worse when a team's red hot like Auburn is. That shot bangs off the shot clock. It's a 50-point lead.
And the biggest loss that Alabama has ever had in their history was a 47-point loss to Southern Cal back in 1971. So they're in danger of that negative record, I should say.
John Gumillion comes in and Caldwell takes a seat. There's John just into the contest. He'll get some valuable minutes here. Shot is outside. That's off the lip. Loose underneath. Ashby follows. Can't get it. The ball slapped out. Here we go. Clifton Robinson. Alabama's at point blank range. Three shots and none of them go down. Hard to explain it today. Just nothing has gone right for Alabama. Chilliest around Hayes. And it won't count. He stepped out of bounds. Hayes, pretty good defense. Shut him off on the baseline, and Chilliest stepped out of bounds.
Cliff Ellis giving some playing time to some of the bench players. Chilliest, Clifton Robinson. Let's watch him on the drive. Nice move, but stepped out of bounds. Alabama's been beat on the drive like that all day today.
And Kendall Mack is off the bench. There's a whistle. And it's going to be against Alabama.
Oh, no. The bread truck.
Kendall Mack. Hayes out of the game and listen to the crowd go crazy. There's going to be some damage done today inside. Look at him against Jeremy Hayes. Size-wise.
He's a large young man.
Yeah. I think Hayes might be giving up 100 pounds in that matchup.
They got to go to him right here. This place will come unglued if he scores.
Baseline move. Gumillion blocked and Hayes comes up with it. Chauncey Jones lost it out of bounds, and a foul going to be called on Fishback. It was 59-30. Alabama was on a bit of a run and looked like they were going to try and fight their way back in it. They haven't scored since.
Watch him on the offensive board. Come on, Kendall, you got to get better position than that. Runs like an offensive lineman, doesn't he?
So Chauncey Jones trying to end this run and finally breaks the drought. As Auburn had scored 21 straight points. Dudley Smith in.
Dudley Smith doesn't have his name on the back of his jersey. He and John Gamillion both walk-ons. Now, I got a problem with that. I'm going to talk to Coach Ellis about that after the game. Kendall Mack comes in off the football team and has his name on the back of his jersey. Now, you explain that to me.
They had to specially order it. That's why. They had to go out and get a bigger jersey. 80-32. 4:15 to go.
Uh-oh, here comes a pick.
Chilius didn't use it. Oh, there's a steal. Chauncey Jones will take it down and finish.
Good job, Chauncey Jones. Good player for Alabama. Having a good season for the Crimson Tide. Tough little point guard out of Chicago.
He's the first Alabama player in double figures. Now he picks up a foul at the other end, his second. 3:57 to go. I'm sure Alabama would just like to get the bus warmed up and get out of here. Regroup a bit.
Put this one behind you and get ready for next week.
Clifton Robinson at the line. Hadn't shot a free throw this season. And hadn't made one yet this season.
Wide receiver.
Yep.
Had a good freshman year for the Auburn football team. Ran back kicks. Did a good job. Very fast.
Had 15 receptions and ran 4 kickoffs back. Still trying to score here. Comes over the loose ball. Well, if he gets it to Mack, Mack might open some holes for him next year.
That's right.
Chilius. Oh, that shot's blocked. Gets it back.
The grasshopper, Neil Ashby.
Gamillion gets into the act. His first 3 of the season.
Auburn's got 2 walk-ons and 2 football players in the game.
Smith takes it in and scores. 85-34. Baseline jump shot, no good. Mazik, the ball knocked away, loose. Dudley Smith comes up with it. Whack. That ball slapped out. And trying to save it, Thrasher steps out of bounds. 3:04 to go in the game, and a timeout is going to be asked for. They're having a lot of fun at Auburn. It's not much fun for Alabama right now. Tigers lead at 85-34.
Everyone needs someone who will be there. Everyone needs someone on their side.
If your car or home is damaged, your Nationwide insurance agent will be there, making sure your property is repaired or replaced to your complete satisfaction, with no hassles. That's our Blue Ribbon Claims Guarantee.
Nationwide is on your side.
In this fast-paced world where there are so many confusing choices in computing and communications, you need a company that can make it all clear, simple, easy. You need a company you can trust with experience in the service you want. Wireless, local, long distance, paging, access to the internet, or customized information processing solutions. You need Alltel for you, your family, your business. Alltel, always more than you thought.
Advance Auto Parts presents part number 16. Larry, our battery expert. Larry installs more AutoCraft batteries in a day than most people do in a lifetime. No matter what you drive, Larry will make sure you get the right battery for your car.
92 a quart?
Yeah.
Advance Auto Parts. The best part is our people.
SEC Basketball is brought to you in part by Advance Auto Parts. The best part is our people.
Auburn with a commanding lead here on the Plains, 85-34. Chauncey Jones, a nice highlight here for the Crimson Tide with the steal and the dunk. 6 foot tall, he can get up for Alabama. The other way, Clifton Robinson, blocked by the Grasshopper, Neil Ashby. Watch it again. The Grasshopper can do it. Yes, sir. He says, get it out of here, Clifton.
He was trying to get an assist. I mean, he was going to try and bang that thing off the board and get the break started the other way.
Neil Ashby's been one of the most exciting players for Alabama. The fans love him because he's an incredible leaper, just a freshman.
Now, the most lopsided victory for Auburn in the series was 43 points back in 1970. And right now they lead it by 51.
Let's give some credit, too, to the assistant coaches today, Bob. Alabama, Bob Marlin, Tyrone Beeman, Kermit Koenig. And Auburn, Mike LaPlante, Shannon Weaver, and Eugene Harris.
Uh-oh. Mack went to the basket and got fouled. Mack was, he had in his eye to do some destruction on the way in there, didn't he?
The big Mack truck. They posted him up low. Taking it to the rack.
Do you think he felt any of that? Those guys banging off him, he probably didn't feel it. Here's Mack. Kendall, a chance for his first point. Nope. Try again. He's got his first point of the season. Kendall Mack.
Crowd loves it.
Driving through and getting fouled on the play was London. And Chile has got him. 2:53 to go in the game. And Auburn leads at 86-34. Terry Bowden was here today, so to get the trophy at halftime, so I'm sure he's sticking around to make sure Kendall Mack gets his running in during the game, sprinting up down the floor.
Training table at Auburn in full effect this year.
London at the line, hits. If you're just joining us, it was a Auburn team that jumped out to a 9-0 lead and never really looked back. They led it at halftime, 45-16. And in this game, Alabama never really made a serious threat. At one point in the first half, it was 32-6. Back, thought about it, takes it, gets his own rebound and scores.
That's incredible. The big fella inside. Nice work.
Mazik hits out front. And back the other way we come. Joe, you know, in a game like this, it's kind of hard not to make light of a certain things. I mean, Kendall Mack obviously entertaining. Clifton Robinson hits a three. His first basket of the day. And first three-pointer of the season. But this Alabama team, they've got to do some soul searching after this.
No question about it. And you can bet that they will, Bob. I'm sure they'll probably have some private team meetings, some one-on-ones. You'll see a lot happen next week with this Alabama team.
This is a Chelius swings in there, can't get it. But this is the time when the veterans on this Alabama team, they've got to rally the troops here a little bit, because no athlete, I don't care what age group, wants anything like this to ever happen to him.
Yeah, you're right. The Alabama will find out who has pride, who wants to step up, who are the leaders that are going to try to prevent this from happening. As you see Kendall Mack, big offensive lineman for the football team, in his first game for Auburn with the putback.
1:35 to go.
You know, the other thing that's going to be interesting to me, Bob, is that Auburn still has to go to Tuscaloosa later in the year. It's been 1984 since Auburn has won in Tuscaloosa, and I'm sure that'll be talked about as they get ready for that game down the road.
Well, we mentioned the fact that Alabama has won 8 of the last 9 in the series, and actually 17 out of 19. How do you explain it?
Clifton Robinson averaged 29 points a game as a senior in high school down in Florida. You see why right there.
That's 14 three-pointers in the game for Auburn. Under a minute to go. London spins in, kicks it out. Thrasher off the mark. And the rebound to Chiliest.
This is going to be the worst defeat in the history of Alabama basketball today, Bob. That's a sad story.
Jump shot, no good off the mark. Chilius scrambles after the rebound. Working hard on the baseline, puts it up, no good. And Alabama comes out of there with it.
Uh-oh.
Ashby, going to, oh, he missed the slam. Mazik puts it back in. 10 seconds to go, 94-40. Fewest points Alabama has scored since 1960. Robinson launches, no good, and the game is over. Auburn with a devastating win over the Alabama Crimson Tide. 94-40 is our final as the Tigers take the tie this afternoon. We'll continue our wrap-up in just a moment, but first a word from your local SEC.